The software provides the capability to import soil sample lab results in an electronic format. Files can be imported and linked to the soil sample points that you previously created and sampled. Not only can you import results directly in the soil sampling editor, you can also import results from the main mapping window. In this tutorial, you will learn how to import electronic lab results, assign the soil attributes, and save the newly imported data. From the File menu, select Read Files, then import a file from a generic source. Choose non-spatial files and the format that your results are in. File formats that can be imported are tab or comma delimited, text or database files that contain soil sample results. Then click Select Files to import. Now, using the Open File dialog, select the location and name of the text file to be imported. Then click Open. You will now be required to set the import parameters for the file you selected, such as if the file contains a header line. Click OK once the parameters have been set. Now, select Data Filters to define what fields from a selected operation will be provided for possible assignments to your import data. If you are importing soil lab results, you would more than likely select the soil sampling operation. This will limit the available fields for linking to your import file to ones that contain soil sampling points. Click Next when done. Next, the Edit Data Filter Results dialog will be displayed and will provide a tree view of all the datasets that met your previous filter selections. You can remove any datasets that are listed if you do not want their associated fields listed in the next dialog. Click Finish once you are satisfied with the datasets listed. Now, the Select Field Name column dialog will be displayed. The Field Names Not Available option is used if the import file does not contain a column with the field name. Choose Select Field Name column if the import file does contain a column that identifies field names for the data. Then pick a column header name that represents the field name. Click Next once you have made your selection. Now, the Assign Import Data by Field Names dialog will be opened. This dialog provides a list of available fields from the system based on the filters you previously set, and then a list of field names for the import file. You then assign the field names from the software to their matching field name in the import file. Once you have assigned all the fields you want to import, click the Finish button. In order to link the data contained in the import file, in this example your lab results, to the data contained in the system, a reference attribute must be chosen to link an attribute in the existing and import dataset. This will help ensure that point number one in the sample point dataset is properly matched with point number one in the import file. Most often, the feature ID in the software soil sampling dataset will be selected and matched with an attribute in the import file, such as sample ID or point name. Click Next once a reference attribute has been selected. You must now assign attributes to the columns you want imported into the system and use to fill in the soil sampling attributes in your dataset. For example, set the required reference attribute you selected in the previous step to an attribute in the import set that will be used to link entries in the two datasets. Then, assign the soil sampling attributes in the system to the columns in the import dataset that correspond to these attributes and that you want to be mappable in the software. Once you have set up the attribute columns to import, you can save a template to use in the future. The template can be loaded the next time you import lab results with identical formatting. Click the Finish button to link and import the lab results into your soil sampling dataset. The imported results will now be in the management tree to be mapped, included in reports, displayed in summaries, and used in queries. You have now learned how to import electronic soil sampling results, assign the desired attributes, and saved the soil sampling attributes that you linked. If you'd like to see more short tutorials from AgLeader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.